Talk to me.
Hey, it's Ms. Shannan here, and I'm at Acme Comedy Company, and I'm hanging out with, it's Costaki Economopoulus?
Costaki Economopoulus.
Say it one more time.
Economopoulus.
So am I the only person that just screwed up your name?
No, believe me. My favorite wrong one is Jacksonville, Florida. The woman comes out, she goes, "Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Econo Cockalockapus." That's a true story.
You sound kind of like a really cute animal, though, with that one.
Econo Cockalockapus?
Yes.
Yes, it's an adorable. He eats eucalyptus. It's Econo Cockalockapus. It's tough growing up named Costaki Economopoulus. Remember when you were a kid, you go in those tour shops, how excited you got, find a keychain with your name on it? In the winter, my friends would go out and pee their names in the snow. They had yet to invent the big gulp.
All right, you talked about where they screwed up your name. What's been the worst gig you've done as a comedian?
Oh, so many. There was one in my early days. I did a one-nighter at a bar in Alabama, which no good story begins with that sentence.
Right.
It was dart night. Mm-hmm. And so they moved the comedy stage from the normal dart area to the other end of the bar.
Right.
Yes. It's always good when the dart players take precedence over the comedy show. And I ended up at the head of a dance floor with no chairs or tables in front of me. Okay. I'm literally talking to an empty dance floor. And there were some people on either side of the dance floor kind of looking in my direction. And occasionally I would get to the beginning of a punchline and the dart players would all cheer about something that was happening. And the four or eight people who were paying attention to me would turn. It was...
So being a kid's tough, I guess. I was watching Oprah. She was warning parents about the dangers of marshmallows. Some kid choked or whatever. Now, I don't mean to seem insensitive, but if your kid can't survive a marshmallow, maybe we don't need him in this country. This kid's not going to grow up to cure cancer. He's probably not going to live through the pencil. La, 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 la. I think we should distribute marshmallows to all of our children as an evolutionary speed bump. Weed out the wheat before they procreate. And if you don't know what procreate means, please tomorrow pick yourself up a f-ing bag of marshmallows.
So.
Okay. Tell us the one joke that you think got you noticed enough to end up on TV.
Ooh.
You're like, there's so many. How do I start?
Well, the name kind of stands out for people. I like crispy, simple jokes, I gotta say. Like, I don't know, I was at the grocery store, I'm standing in front of the grapes, and I'm thinking, where's the line between sampling and stealing, you know? Right. How many grapes can you eat before somebody freaks out, right, runs over, kicks you out of the store? 19. So I like jokes that sort of have like a crispy, clean, sort of couple of beats to them like that, you know?
All the bad messages for kids. The Tooth Fairy. Body parts are worth cash. Santa Claus, sit on a bearded stranger's lap, tell him your name and where you live. Halloween, take candy from strangers. And if they won't give you any, vandalize their homes. Remember the game Red Rover, Red Rover? Right? One kid would run over, and if he breaks through that line, he gets to stay on that side, which is basically our immigration policy.
I try to do some political stuff, too, and some social stuff, and silly stuff, and smart stuff. I got kind of a... I try to have range in the show.
A cornucopia of comedy. That's what we get.
Oh, that's a good album title.
See, I couldn't say your last name, but I can say cornucopia, so at least I brought something to the table.
Very...
So, my other guy obsession, online poker. Oh, that is the crack cocaine of the internet there. I don't know how you stop playing. Oh. At least with online porn, there's sort of a built-in endpoint. Eventually with porn, you're like, well, I'm done with that for a while, you know. Poker goes on all night. I feel like I should touch myself while I'm playing just so eventually I will f***ing fall asleep and stop.
Yeah, I actually have a brand new comedy album that just came out this week called Mission Economopoulus.
Oh, wow.
And you can get it at Costaki.com.
Okay, I like
and
it.
And if you can't spell my name, get close and Google will say, did you mean Costaki Economopoulus? Google knows me, so that's something.